What's up, guys? Stardust Hero here, back with Phoenix Eye.
Yo.
Or for the first time, I don't know which I'm gonna upload the shit, to be honest. Mm-hmm. Always gonna be a dice roll. So today we're talking about the top 6 alternative game modes or rule sets for Yu-Gi-Oh! Mm-hmm. So we weren't too clear to each other what the specific guidelines are to introduce mm-hmm. variety. I mean, if we're too strict with the rules, the top 6 would be too the same, you know, the difference would be big. So I'll kick it off with my number 6.
Mm-hmm.
So my number 6 is Speed Duel, aka Duel Links.
Yeah, okay.
So the Duel Links format, the 3 monsters, small deck. At first I wasn't a big fan of this because I felt like it just simplified the game to a situation where it isn't that interesting anymore. But I gave Duel Links a chance, really liked that. I don't like what to do with Speed Duels in real life. Selling the old cards as new cards, asking way too high of a price for some of the cards. Not a fan of that. But the idea behind it is quite cool. The skills really add a lot to Yu-Gi-Oh! You know? Mm-hmm. They add a new ceiling. Makes building decks more interesting. It's a shame some of the decks are, some of the skills are a bit too specific. Like, all my monsters gain a little bit of attack. Yeah, I mean, that's very unoriginal. But like the Fortune Ladies ones, my level increases, the wall. I don't know, there are a lot of interesting skills. So, what's your number 6?
Well, my number 6 is. I put Turbo Dueling on number 6.
Like the anime style.
Yeah, the anime style on motorcycles.
Card games on motorcycles.
I put it kind of low because it's still not really one that is brought into the real world, so to say. Yeah.
Which is a shame.
It would be really fun, kind of hard to to pull off, but sure.
What do you mean? We got motorcycles, we got dual discs.
Fair,
what could possibly go wrong?
I mean, all we need now is perfect hologram technology, and then we're basically there.
I mean, I read an article recently that Konami's actually planning on that.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah.
Who knows? Turbo Duel soon.
But yeah, I agree. The format itself is really nice. But I'll talk about that later. Spoiler. So my number 5 is Sealed Duel. So what this means is that you go to the store. Mostly it's a real life event.
Mm-hmm.
You buy, for example, 5 packs. Mostly used to sneak duels and you have the battle packs. And then you build a deck out of those cards and battle against others.
Mm-hmm.
It allows a simpler game state, like that we're used to. I mean, more than Yu-Gi-Oh! Is so fast and stuff.
Yeah,
I sound like such a boomer right now. But it enables a casual level of play that's really challenges you to build your own deck in such a way. It's mostly a lot of fun.
Yeah, it kind of takes you back to the school ground era of Yu-Gi-Oh!
Exactly.
Basically.
And I like it. It's a slower pace of gameplay, and that I really enjoy it. So what's your number 5?
Deckmasters, this is a thing that I saw coming by once. I didn't actually see the part of the anime where they used this, but it seemed really interesting, kind of like you have a boss monster in your deck that has a special ability as long as it's just kind of your boss monster, and then you can also summon it with... I'm not exactly sure how it worked, I'm pretty sure it was kind of like skills and duel links that are tied to a monster.
I have no idea what this even is.
Yeah, you should look it up, it's pretty funny. Basically, it's you choose one of your monsters as to be your deck master, and it has a special skill that you can use, kind of like dueling skills.
Yeah, this is from the virtual arc or something.
I'm not really sure, something like that.
Yeah.
But and eventually you can also summon this monster when very specific conditions are met, but when that monster dies, you just kind of lose the game, for as far as I know. It's kind of like a real boss monster that you select from your game that gives a bit of flavor to your deck, you know.
That does sound like a lot of fun. Never tried it myself, but that sounds like something I would want to try. I mean, if I lose my boss monster, I lost anyway, so...
Yeah, basically.
In most decks. You're gonna have Xian, of course. I'm gonna have Jinzo. Oh, you want to summon something? No! So, my number 4 is Turbo Duel.
Mm-hmm.
I have it a bit higher on my list, because I played a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh! DS games, 2010, sure. 2009, 2011. They actually featured the format, and it's a lot of fun. It gives a new dynamic to deck building as well. We can suddenly start running banned cards on your deck. But they cost a lot of speed counters, so that's kind of an offset between it. And just adds a new twist to Yu-Gi-Oh! Because normal spells don't exist anymore, you need to run speed spells. So, it one slows down the game, and two adds a new dynamic to it, and it's something I really like. Mm-hmm. It's a shame they never did this in real life. Like, seriously, just you don't need actual motorcycles, you know, you can just print Speed World.
Yeah, okay.
Print like 2 packs with speed spells.
Mm-hmm.
Let people have fun.
Yeah, you could make basically kind of just a tabletop variation of it.
Wouldn't be
that hard.
Just 2 special packs with speed spells would be a lot of fun. But
exactly.
Konami's anti-fun, it seems. So what's your number 4?
My number four is Concentration Dueling, which is a very odd... I didn't actually see it yet in the anime, but I know of it. It's, it's essentially the kind of dueling where you put all of your cards face down, and you just kind of have to guess one, whether it's a spell trap or monster, I believe, and then pick it up, and if you're correct, you get to play it, and if you're wrong, you get to you have to put it back down. So it's kind of like...
Memory.
Yeah, that's in Dutch it's called Memory, but I believe the English version is just Concentration.
Would make sense.
That's literally what it's named after, I believe.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
How the name...
But yeah, it just sounds like the type of game you can just that you would just be able to play with your normal Yu-Gi-Oh cards just to spice up.
Yeah, just give your deck here, we're just gonna toss
it. Yeah, exactly, just toss it on the ground.
And then monster cards. Oh wait, I only had monster cards in this deck.
The only thing I'm thinking of is that you could also just build decks specifically for this kind of game mode where you just put only one type of card in your deck.
But then you only have one type of card. So if you, for example, only run spells, your opponent's like, I'm gonna run anti-spell card, and
monster card.
Or you're just Yugi from the, or you're just the main character and always guess right.
Yeah, that's true. Hearth card.
Or just cheat by marking your sleeves. Anyways, my number three is the Scavenger Challenge. This is something I did on a channel a long while ago. The idea is simple. You pick a random structure deck. Now, the way you randomly pick it is up to you. I just use the slot machine with all structure decks in it. You get three copies of that structure deck. And then the only new way for you to obtain cards is by defeating somebody in a duel, checking the replays. Any card you remove from the field or destroyed are now added to your inventory.
Oh, nice.
That's the way you need to build your deck. So if you want to upgrade your deck, you need to beat others. I might expand on this in the future and reintroduce it to the channel, but it was a lot of fun to do back in the day. Yeah. People weren't that interested in that though. Some people copied the challenge actually back then. So if we get more mainstream, I can do it again. Maybe you can do it.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, it sounds like a bit of a roguelike variation of Yu-Gi-Oh! This sounds pretty cool.
It's basically like how the video games work, but then online against other people. It's a lot of fun. So what's your number three?
I have speed dueling right here on number three. That's well, I am a duelings player, so it's kind of a bit too nervous. I mean, I'll have to admit that the actual speed dueling version is a bit scuffed because you just have much... I believe you only have like first generation Yu-Gi-Oh cards, basically. Yeah. Just different structure decks of it.
Just like Duel Links was back in the day.
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of like an incomplete version, but if we look more at Duel Links, it's just kind of like a more playable version of Yu-Gi-Oh for newer players, especially.
Yeah, because new Yu-Gi-Oh, like if I were to take you, give you the cards, don't explain anything.
Yeah, no, I don't know what to do. Yeah, I started playing the game, Duel Links, that's basically my introduction to Yu-Gi-Oh, and that's what allowed me to slowly get into it, so now I kind of understand the game. It's a real step up from just directly going into the OG game.
Yeah, just sort of Dark Magician. I'm supposed to tribute what? Monster?
Exactly.
Yeah.
What's the tribute song?
So, my number two is a bit specific. It's more of a format than alternative game mode. It's called Cross Banlist. Most famously known from Lithium's Cross Banlist Cup. In my opinion, still the best content on YouTube, although I'm not satisfied with this year. Basically, you take multiple decks from different eras of the game, like you take a deck from 2005, get a deck from 2008, and see how they do. So you don't actually customize your own deck, you take decklists from the past, else you can easily cheat and cheese. But you basically, it's like an all-stars version of Yu-Gi-Oh!
That's pretty cool.
I really like it. Yeah, we could always do that in the future, you didn't play those decks back in the days, it's gonna be hard for you.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. We kind of do it with the gauntlets at times.
Yeah,
like
kind of.
Edison gauntlet, head gauntlet, we did a few of them.
But mostly you playing the original decks and me just trying to to beat it.
I mean, yeah, because giving those decks to him would be hugely unfair because he has no idea.
Especially if I have about 5 minutes to figure it out and then about 10 seconds per turn to to read the cards and see what I have to do.
So what's your number two?
Battle Royales, in fact. It's the kind of the type of Yu-Gi-Oh! Where you just play with multiple people. There are four people here, let's
I was thinking like Fortnite, it was like...
sounds lit, I'm not talking about Duelist Kingdom or what it's called.
Yeah,
that was basically
like just imagine a Battle Royale Yu-Gi-Oh! Game. You get a base, cut your deck, and then you pick up cards from the ground.
It
like,
would be kind of
yes, Raigeki.
Nice!
Okay, and then you just start throwing Raigeki at the board, it's just like the fight in the anime does.
Yeah, no, I'm more talking about just the actual four-man duels and stuff like that. Just
It's Wait, free-for-all or tag?
Free-for-all, mostly. That's I can just imagine if that would be more popular, the kind of bullshit things you could do if you'd actually synergize your decks together in order to take out people that just... Having one person be basically a support deck for the other person in order to pull off insane combos that would just get you instant wins.
By the way, also fun. I've done it with friends a few times in real life. Mm-hmm. It was kind of hard to pull off because you need this rare thing called friends. So I don't know what kind of booster box contains them. But
yeah.
Then again, there's this card called Box of Friends, so maybe I just need to get that one.
Good try.
Anyways, my number one is Booster Battle. It's a format we actually do on the channel, hashtag self-promotion. Basically, you take a set from the past, like let's say Legends of Blue-Eyes. Mm-hmm. You ignore the ban list and construct a deck based on that pack, and you only use cards from that pack. Means you can use 3 Raigeki if Raigeki's in there, you can use 3 Monster Reborn if Monster Reborn's in there. Then you just battle against each other with cards from the same pack. Something I've been doing with Phoenix Eye, and honestly, it's my favorite type of content to do, I really enjoy it.
Yeah.
We do it pretty often, and I really like it.
Yeah, for me it's also a great way to get a bit introduced to all the different cards that are in the game, because there's a lot.
There's a lot of cards, there's 10,000?
Something like that.
Yeah, I believe it's exactly 10,000 actually. No. Well, we got newer cards, so it's even more. What's your number one?
My number one is actually the kind of board game version of Yu-Gi-Oh! That's introduced in Dueling Kingdom against the Paradox Brothers. I'm not sure if you watched that before.
No.
It's essentially a version of Yu-Gi-Oh! Where your cards manifest, your monster cards manifest as kind of characters on the board. And once per turn they get to move an amount of squares equal to their level. And it's a really odd variation. It's kind of like Yu-Gi-Oh! On a board. And you have to move around your monster. You get to place traps on squares. It's kind of where that's one card.
Duelist of Roses, is that a bit like it? Or
I'm not really sure, but it's kind of... Anyway, in the anime it was kind of introduced, but with that card, what was it again? The level 6 card that was just a 3000 defense mace.
Labyrinth Wall.
Yeah, that one. That was basically, that card was played and a giant mace came up and now you have to maneuver your monsters through it in order to... It was I thought it was a pretty fun variation, but it would be really hard to bring to real life.
It does sound fun, I just don't know it. Anyways, those were our top 6 alternative game modes. Any we missed? Any you think don't belong on our lists? tell us in the comments. What's your favorite game mode to play? I mean, for us it's now clear, but what's yours? Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Star is Yu-Gi-Oh! And
Phoenix Eye.
Signing out.